was head of the Institute of Contemporary Arts in Britain. I don't know how I got that job and got sacked from it, actually. I felt that conceptualism was going up its own arse, basically. Every day there was another ludicrous example of what art is. And I kind of decided to be the first person to put a finger up to it and just go, yeah, come on, let's get some reality. I'm quite proud of that move. It seemed to have floored the contemporary art world. A lot of what's happened since then has been real art, you know, real stuff, made of stuff. And this is why I love Banksy.
Giving a dinner party with my husband Percy. It's for very important people, some of whom I know very well and some of whom I don't know.
Joan Collins has just always been an icon of mine. I just absolutely think that she's one of the best bits of talent to come out of Britain. I want to see more of Joan Collins.
I'm very excited, and I love having dinner parties. I love having dinner parties for like 8 people, because so many restaurants today you can't hear yourself talk because, you know, the music and the acoustics. So I think people like coming to somebody's house. These are various invitations that I got, but the one that is really interesting is this one that I got on Friday, and this is a VIP preview of an exhibition of Donald Beschler, Jean-Michel Basquiat and Banksy.
One of the things I really wanted to throw light on was the different types of fame, and of course you've got the difference in approaches from Joan Collins to Banksy, and they're poles apart. So to bring them together, one fame, this magnificent fame that walks around being famous, being the personality all the time, and the other person, someone you would never know who he is. His fame is just his work, and if his fame is anything else, it's his lack of willingness to court fame.
I'm very excited we're going to have Banksy. He does absolute works of art, and they sell for £980,000, and people like Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie and Madonna buy his work.
Who knows if they've actually bought his work, though? That's the question. Because he's anonymous, you don't know what is his work and what isn't his work. And I get the feeling that he doesn't care whether it's his work or not his work that's being sold. It's not the point. If we like it and if it represents what Banksy represents, I don't think it matters whether it's real or not real.
People copying my work or claiming to be me or claiming they've slept with me, I've said this before, it's like each their own, I suppose. To me, it's a fucking joke.
He's very reclusive. I've never met him, and he's being brought by Tamara Beckwith, who's a really good friend of mine. And Tamara is, she's a socialite, she's a girl about town, she's a lot of fun, she's very bubbly, and she's seen it at every party.
So really, I had to cancel, I felt so dreadful. But I got sick, and I was all hot and bothered. So I called them this morning and I said, guys, just can't do it.
Just kidding.
Sorry, I'm going to annoy somebody today.
If you were asked to give, say, 4 words to describe Joan, there's just so many that are very stereotypical. And I think, you know, she's just so dramatic, an old school star, and, you know, the white teeth and the makeup and the hair and everything. I mean, it all just gels to sort of one big ball of fabulousness, really.
And it's difficult to know now whether she's an actress who plays someone called Joan Collins almost on a day-to-day basis, or whether this is her. The lines have become so blurred. but whatever happens, very impressive person to be around, and I don't know anyone who's met her that hasn't come away feeling they've been in the presence of majesty.
There's two Joans, isn't there? You've got the public Joan, which is the stereotypical showbiz, old school star, always immaculate, always looks $1 million. And then you have her private side, which is really, really funny. She's very in love, so she's got lovely Percy.
It was a hard decision to make. We thought to ourselves that it's rather undignified, frankly, to have to open our lives, our house, our belongings to the cameras.
This is Percy's first flying lesson. Mum's not too keen about his flying at the moment, but it's a bit of a moot point. But anyways, this is where we'll be seated tonight.
Then there's Stephen Amos. Stephen is a wonderful comedian, very, very funny, and lots of fun.
Do you normally go to dinner parties?
I normally eat dinner, if that's what you mean. what kind of a question is that? Do I normally get to go to these posh dinner parties? No. Look at me. I'm a young lad from Tooting Broadway. All right?
This is like having dinner with the Queen. I mean, everything is laid out. There's an order you have to go through. There's a place setting for everybody. It's not like going to KFC.
So you're going to dinner with Joan Collins. Have you met Joan before?
I'm not really in the mood, if I'm honest.
It's really annoying having that thing in my face.
Then we have Paul de Freitas, who I do not know.
I have met Joan several times, actually. Usually in the Ivy restaurant and at theatres, and each time she's always said, you know, we must get together, you must come over for supper one evening, and here's the big night.
I've been Paul off and on for about 7-8 years. He just phones up, and I don't know when I'm going to get home, because he's a typical person who likes nightlife. He's a bit of a party animal.
I'm a freelance television casting director, which means I have to find actors and actresses to appear in different films, television commercials, TV projects. And along the way, I found myself turning up in different television projects myself.
Joan Collins, absolute delight. Although she's got quite a tough exterior, and I've seen her play many tough parts, strangely enough. You know, she frightens the life out of me when I see her playing certain characters, but she's quite sensitive.
You don't always want the same group that knows everybody. You want to have different people, because different people spark off more different conversations, people who have opposing points of view about politics, religion, sexuality, what's going on in the world. That makes it very interesting. I think that's all. Have I left anyone out? Yes, I have. Anne Mitchell. Anne Mitchell is a very, very serious actress, and she calls herself an actor. Now, I highly disapprove of this because I think that the sexes should be delineated by the sexes.
Joan's an icon, obviously, but she's also a woman who did an enormous amount in Dynasty to change the way that mature women were looked at in television and film. I almost believe single-handedly she did that.
So I've got her a little gift. Dear, it's very English to drink rosé, isn't it? Mm. You know, we had that's her favourite drink from San Gimignano when she goes to Saint-Constant with her huge sun hat. But of course, she never goes in the sunshine. That's why her skin looks so amazing.
Everybody has at the moment a gift apart from yourself and Mr. G.
There, I think.
Oh, all right.
And you.
All right,
and
I'll
I think
get that
we should have a plate there.
Right here.
You know, a serving plate
right.
That will be taken away when they bring the first course.
Right.
I'm having a bit of a conundrum. I mean, on the whole, you know, normally I just pop something on and then it works. I don't want one of these girls who goes through her whole wardrobe and then freaks out that nothing works. So I think I'm quite organised today. I suppose whenever you think of your ideal dinner, you'd always like somebody sort of super intellectual or scientific or something so you could learn something. And then somebody who's sort of quite controversial. So I suppose that one we've got ticked because Banksy is quite controversial.
So many people like to think they know Banksy or like to think they're part of it. Nearly everyone knows someone who knows him, a friend whose flatmate lived with him.
And then that friend knows Banksy.
or made a stencil for him.
The owner of the pub knows him.
Or used to hang out in Germany with him.
But in fact, the owner of the pub doesn't know him. His wife knows him.
He's always someone else's friend.
Always a trail that leads to nothing, because nobody really knows who he is.
I mean, everyone's a wannabe now, doesn't they?
Right, so this all looks very good. I don't think I really need this cushion back here, do you think?
I'll remove that one.
I mean, shall we? Do you want to take it away?
Thank you.
And the bell.
No, back to the kitchen, please.
I have to go in for the bell.
Shall I come?
No. Wait one moment.
All right. See if you can do something about the nose bit.
Of course I will. I'll do that in
Thank you. What do I do now? I'm going mad!
One of the people who I'm most impressed with is Jory White, his London PR. Now, her job is solely to make sure no one knows what he looks like.
It's an interesting challenge, because in fact, what we've managed to do is we've managed to create this enigma about him that has made his work worth more, because people are enthralled by the mystery.
I'm just being me. I was walking around normally. I'm not walking around in shaded windows, bulletproof glass, fucking hat down, pulled out of clubs, trying to wear like that fat cow Tracy Emin, trying to wear a skirt too short for me, you know, trying to look like 22 and she's double that, you know. I'm not being anything that I'm... Maybe people want me to be. But fucking sweet rappers are everywhere.
My job is very much to create as much confusion as possible.
In this film, I had to pixelate him, and we've changed his voice and we've subtitled him.
Who met him?
To begin with, I was pressing, thinking, well, it'd be nice to show his face, to be the director or the producer that brings Banksy out the closet, so to speak, and lets us see what he looks like.
Not sure my mother would approve.
But really, what fun is that? Do I want to know who Banksy is really, if I'm a punter? Do I really? I may think I do. But actually, isn't it far more interesting that I haven't got a clue?
I don't think people do really want to know why. Just spoil it, wouldn't it?
In not knowing the guy, I think the pictures hold more of an appeal in not actually knowing what the guy's like, because you kind of get to see the guy through the pictures.
The fact that he's got the air of, like, anonymity about him, the fact, you know, like, we know, like, Tracy and all the Damien Hirst and like this, and basically who puts a price on their work.
I mean, his work is wonderful anyway. I think he's a great artist. But because he's working so anonymously, that's the situation. That's why his work is so highly valued or prized or appreciated in some places.
Okay, I'm going to grab a water, because I'm sure he hasn't got one in that. We're going in a cab to Oxford. I hope he's going to pay. Okay, let's get my stuff together. We don't think he's going to come to the front door. Obviously not.
He could be anyone. He could be me. He could be you.
Fucking odor.
And the fact it could be any of us is kind of fascinating. It's kind of the Robin Hood of art.
Brian, pick the rubbish up. Brian, the rubbish!
I've been Brian's driver for 7.5, 8 years. And I bought the cab to drive him around in, specifically, because obviously we needed something inconspicuous.
Such a messy apus.
What should we do with the banana?
I'll have it.
Somebody told me the other day that he was bound to be a crack addict from a Wolverhampton council estate. I said, oh, really?
You know, you ask anyone on the street who Banksy is, and their views change.
Banksy?
Yeah.
He's an arsehole. He looks like a tosser. I've got to be honest with you, son.
Rough and ready.
He's not a male model or anything.
Blonde and wears a hat.
I don't know much about him, no.
In the interest of tender, you know, fuck me. I could do that, I'm telling you. When I'm sober, I could do anything, but when I'm drunk, I'm in trouble. Yeah, I ain't gonna try to be sensible. Not for you, son.
I'm sure if they saw me, they'd probably be quite disappointed, really. So How far are we going, Jules? How far do we go?
Hey?
Do you mind if I just use the toilet for a clip?
Just this minute?
Please, yeah, yeah. Jules?
Hey? Yep.
Do you want me to get the key?
No, my husband's in there. He might be a bit weird if he finds a strange man in his house.
As far as I can see, look at what other celebrities do to keep themselves secretive and do the exact opposite. I don't think there's any leaving restaurants through the kitchen.
Walk in like a normal dude, sit down and have dinner.
There's no security guards or bouncers.
No way. You could never have a bodyguard.
There's nothing at all. They very, very carefully just work on being, on making sure that he just disappears into the background.
It's great fun. It's exactly the opposite of what we do for all of our other clients. We make all these people well-known and famous and get them interviewed, and we don't have to do that. It's fantastic. It's just such a great strategy.
What have we got, Jules, in there? Sweets.
Fruit pastels, jelly sweets.
Having this bizarre situation where you have him talking about nothing of any interest a lot of the time, with all the protection of a CIA witness, just made me laugh.
They're not on the floor. I wonder if it was the floor.
I might not rescue those ones.
I was the DOP on the secret Banksy shoot. I signed a huge form to say that I could talk to nobody, this is all very secret, that my children would be sent away to a gulag should I talk. I mean, we had signed something that basically we were not to talk about anything, but we really didn't know what we were talking about anyway. If someone had come and said to me, you know, here's £500, tell me what's gone on, I wouldn't have known.
Quite rare to have a woman taxi driver.
No, she's not a taxi driver, she's...
Well, she's your own driver.
Yeah,
yeah. Well, it's going to be quite long to go to Oxford in a taxi. At least we don't have the meter ticking on the bright side.
A friend gave me some magazines, amongst them was a copy of The Lady. That nice posh little magazine that ladies ask for housekeepers and things. There was an advert in there, somebody needing some help with driving. And I thought, well, this will be a nice old lady who needs taking to get her prescriptions and things. So I answered, and when he asked to meet me at the Ace Cafe on the North Circular Road, I didn't think this was going to be our average old age pensioner, really.
How old's April now? Seven, and Ollie's... Well, she's got two grandchildren.
We got on. And I thought, this is too good to be, you know, to be missed, really.
You say you've been down to Joan's house?
I have.
So I've got a present for her here, just I'll show it to you later on.
Often you meet somebody that you've kind of put on a pedestal and they're all a bit disappointing in the flesh. And, you know, they're not really that great and you realise they're just human.
She wraps you up, really.
What do you call it? Does it have a name?
No, it's just one. It's my own self.
You get this shit that is Tracy M in an unmade fucking bed. Excuse me, but you know, that is not art, is it? That is, as soon as you move there, that is not art, is it? That is a thought. And all this crap about the turn of prize winners light going on and off.
I think it's a bit of emperor's new clothes.
Got a little more.
The really interesting thing about Banksy is that in complete contrast to normal young artists who have themselves become the art and ponce around being shocking, he's removed himself from the public eye and allowed anyone to be Banksy.
This image of me, if I came out and was on every chat show and every magazine cover, I think it'd probably spoil it. They wouldn't like it as much, but nevertheless, I'm not doing it for that purpose. That's one of the reasons why I did this film, because I think people think this is a some kind of device for me to sell or to make my work more popular.
I haven't brought Anne to anything like this in the last 7 or 8 years. She normally prefers to go to places in Hampstead, maybe one or two restaurants in London, but Hampstead is her favourite place to go. And was quite excited about meeting Banksy, very much so. She was saying how much she enjoyed his art and how that he seems to be the voice of the people through his art. And of course, for Anne to say something like that means that she's given a lot of thought to his work.
What I love about Banksy is his work that's famous.
I think it's very refreshing. Somebody who doesn't want to be famous, who wants to remain anonymous, I think that's incredible. Absolutely amazing in this day and age.
When you walk around some of his exhibitions, you can see that all the security guards and all the PRs have been very carefully told to remind people there's a bit of Banksy in all of us.
No, she didn't mention Joan at all, not in the car. Not that I remember, but of course I was concentrating because we were coming down quite fast.
I like to give lots of parties. I've given dozens and dozens in my life. But a sit-down dinner is very dangerous. It's the most dangerous party you can give. You never know at the last minute that somebody's not going to turn up. People might be terribly late. So you keep your fingers crossed that everything's going to go according to plan.
Well, I'm expecting something grand. I'm expecting a lot of grounds. I would imagine it's very serene, I would think, very elegant, gracious. I'm expecting a lot.
Swearing is not, you know, too good. I mean, the occasional F word, but S word, but not too much. Bawdy stories about nether regions are not really good.
Yeah. Too many penis jokes. No. An evening.
Oh my God. Looks like Brideshead Revisited. It's amazing.
We've called this party for 8. So if people arrive 8:10, that's perfect.
Yeah.
Well, I think it's time for us to go. I'll go. You're going to change, aren't you?
Yes,
yeah, definitely. Okay.
Mitchell, welcome.
Thank you. Oh, it's just lovely. Oh, I love it.
Would you like to take a seat?
Yes, I'd love to. Thank
you. I'll go and tell Miss Collins you're here.
Thank you.
Bloody hell, Mum's going to have an absolute shit. She hates it when people turn up early.
You know, I am not pleased about this at all. She's early, I could be downstairs. I wanted to go downstairs and light the candles and put my bag in place. I don't think that's right. It's terribly rude to be early.
Hi, Anne. Tara, I'm Joan's daughter. Hi. Nice to meet you.
And you.
I'm just, I'd come and keep you company till they come down. Did you have a long journey in? Here he is, the man of the moment.
Nice to see you. How are you?
I'm just going to go off and help in the kitchen.
Yes, of course. How are you, Anna?
Hi.
Nice to see you.
You too.
I am so happy to meet you. My God, a lot. Happy hug.
Phew. That was a good hide and seek, wasn't it? Cheers.
I think we should all have one for that.
although we had a message to deliver, the film has a purpose. Everyone had something they were going to bring to this scenario.
This is fabulous.
Oh, darling, well, listen, John and I, we could tell a story or two. Dogging, you name it, we do it.
One thing I hadn't expected was for Stephen, though, to start exploring his sexuality on camera, because he just left his girlfriend behind, and here was he, obviously flirting with Paul.
Turn back! We're going back to my place. Forget Joe. Forget dinner.
Esprit, one of my favourite shops. Oh, my God. Beautifully wrapped. I love this purple on Esprit. There is. Oh. That is beautiful. Oh!
Were you good at art at school?
Oh, it may sound very good now. It is what comes from living you.
He just came in and announced that Paul and Stephen were coming. What is going on? Are they here?
Mr. and Mrs. Gibson, Mr. De Freitas.
Hi, Paul. How are nice you? To see
Lovely
you.
To see you too.
How are you?
Yeah, very well. Nice.
Thank you very much.
Hello. I'm Joan. Hi. How are you, Paul?
Very well.
Good night to see you. Oh, wonderful.
Thank you.
Wonderful.
Well, our shoes seem to be matching.
Oh, yeah, so they do, don't they? Paul, do you know Anne Mitchell?
Oh, of course.
Hi, Stephen.
How are you?
How are you? Good to see you.
Thank you.
You look nice and summery.
Joan, a little gift.
Okay.
And I hope the seat.
Ah, yes. I remember this. Filled with herbs and spices from exotic places.
I bought a bottle of Cinzano. Because, you know, she used to do the commercials years ago. And I have to be honest and say, you know, I was a kid when they were going out, and it's such happy memories, and I thought she'd appreciate the gesture. You know, I still think she'd see the funny side of it.
We have a special cocktail.
Oh, fantastic.
Made with Cinzano.
Oh, well, I want one of those. I'd love one.
Will you?
Yeah, absolutely. Right. Perfect. Please take it.
Oh, right. Okay.
I actually ended up wearing half of it down my shirt earlier on, and I thought, well, actually, so did she in one of the commercials. So if it's good enough for Joan Collins, it's good enough for me. That's what I say.
What we do now, this is actually quite a pleasant drink. It's better than a martini. It's something that they made for us in the Ivy, and it's quite fantastic. You just swirl this Cinzano around the glass and pour it away. Where's the vodka? Is this the vodka? Yes, fantastic. And we just pour it in there. Oh, great, fantastic. Well, we'll have to start that one again.
And little something. It's Cristal.
Oh, lovely. Well, next time I have to throw something over an old battleship, I'll use this. So, where's Naomi, your girlfriend?
Sadly, she can't make it.
Can't make it?
Yes. Joe was like, where's your girlfriend? And I went, ooh, she's not here. And you could tell she was a bit narked by it.
It's fine. I'm sorry she got car sick. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Oh, don't worry. We'll sort it out.
Naomi hasn't shown up.
Okay.
Stephen's girlfriend. So we're short one woman.
Right.
And you're a woman.
Am I?
Yes. It's rather casual, you know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, everybody's dressed very casually, so okay. Would you mind?
Can I go up into Mum's room and borrow something? I don't know. Just out to the left.
Okay, fine.
been gone for ages.
I think he's having a snoop around your house.
Snoop around. I'm gonna take care of him.
I quite like those because they're very understated, these dogs.
Paul?
Isn't it gorgeous? Probably hard not to be in a good mood here every day. Look at that lovely, just all those lovely little deer running around.
Paul?
Hi.
What are you doing in here?
They're just looking around. It's just so amazing. So many things, Jane.
Yes, I know.
Oh, thank you, Julie.
And the present. What? The present.
Have you been in here?
Well, no. Let me go. To...
This is like the small drawing room. Hello.
Oh, amazing. This is your pianist.
How are you? Okay, very well. Nice to see you.
Hello, good. I'm Paul. Nice to meet you.
I think the biggest audience I've done is about 60,000 people, and that was twice a day. So that was really quite a job, but I think playing in a small room with no one there is actually, in a way, just as difficult.
Hello. How do you do, Miss Beckwith?
Good evening.
And you're Mr. Ryan. How do you do? Please follow me. Mrs. Gibson? Miss Beckwith, Mr. Ryan.
Thank you so much.
We're a bit late, I'm afraid. I'm so sorry.
Hello, you must be Brian. Of course you're Brian.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, come on in
and
have a drink.
I said to Joan, there's so many sort of like knick-knacks, as my mother would call them, and I'm glad I don't have to dust them.
Yes. I know. Have you got any
coats?
Yes. Yeah, I was
going to put up your nose.
I'm sure. I'm
sure. That's too many decisions. Something with some...
Look who's here!
Hello.
It's Tamara and Brian.
Kiss, darling. You look gorgeous.
Thank you so much.
Fabulous.
And...
There was the whole mysticism bit of, someone's arrived, who could this be? And this guy came in and he looked quite ordinary, really. But obviously, everything changed within the room. It was a kind of a bit of a power shift, you know.
Oh, Brian, this is fantastic.
It really is, it really is. Can we put it on the table here?
Of course.
We all sat in the control room thinking, how do you know that he is that man? But there was definitely a tension in the room at points. Joan was... Just everybody went quiet. You know, people focused all their energies towards him in a certain way. And I don't know, I wanted him to be a bit different, I guess, because nobody knows who he is.
I wanted a Lucas aid if it's possible.
Yeah, just
a bit.
Flushed.
You do look flushed.
It's still a bit much, a bit overwhelmed.
Am I finding it? I'm finding it, to be completely honest, a fucking nightmare.
Your mum was very good, very, very good. She's like I've always been.
Have you?
Really, yeah, really good. I'm very flattered that tonight she's asked me along. I've never really come out before, but...
You don't get out often, then?
I didn't know it was going to be this way.
No, he said Lucozade to me. What's Lucozade? It's a sort of medicinal yellowish drink, Joe.
It's been years now.
Yeah, she was good. She was like my mother, really. Joan Collins. Always liked her. Yeah, she's a nice lady. But tell you there's other people around here.
To be honest, I wasn't going to be sitting down and eating tonight, so this is all kind of new to me. I don't know all of these people. I know Tamara. Is it Paul De Freitas? I don't know.
I think Joan could invest in some air conditioning. Mm. I'm going to have a word with her later.
Yeah, I like it.
Well, it's traditional.
No.
Yeah, no, I've never met her. I don't know who she is, to be honest with you.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? I mean, he said, don't auction it. He said, I'm not going to auction it.
That's all I can tell you. I'm not really a wealth of information. Area. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. And we said, well, our car is right there. Can't we just go get it? And we're just trying to protect you, ma'am. And I don't know.
Deer.
I get dirt.
And the other people, there were some, like, I was like half laughing half the time because I don't know if they were being serious about what they were coming out with, or whether they just wanted to get a sound bite, or just like a lot of them want to get their tuck me out of in and just saying things just to sort of get the camera onto them, you know, it's all a little bit of that.
They're all totally nuts. They're all totally nuts. I mean, everyone looks completely mad. It's fine.
It's all right.
Chill. It's fine. I haven't done anything wrong.
Don't Nico. He's just like,
no, I know. It's fine.
So, lovely jobs. I'm happy with this. What do you think? Sometimes I like to have a gab.
Oh,
no. That's just nice. Otherwise, it's like too much to see your face.
No?
I never saw you smoking if you weren't drinking.
I was smoking on the set when I was working on a movie with Betty Davis. She was going around smoking like a chimney the whole time. And all of the rest of us, who were all like 18 or 19, were smoking. Finalmente!
The goose here. Yep. Put the ice in first. Ice in first. Ice. Don't do it with your hands, but no, no, that's a single note.
Oh, you are lovely.
Brian, you're here, darling.
The big challenge of making this film was it all had to be shot in a day, and I only had Banksy from 12 in the morning till 12 midnight. And I remember working towards that kind of Cinderella moment.
For me, it was very surreal. I was kind of like a goldfish in a bowl. I didn't know what was going on. I was just there doing my job.
Can you take that cling film off?
Yeah, of course.
Nico, can you do that?
Yeah.
What happened, I mean?
Gets car sick.
This is known as a pregnant pause.
Yes, I did apologise. All the amuse-bouche are ready. Right, fine.
Do you want them now?
No,
you
not
want
quite. I'm waiting till they're seated.
I'm not used to you not being near him now. It feels like you're...
Darling, I'm not used to me not being near him now. After that car journey, dear.
What happened in the car?
We just seemed to be in that car for hours, didn't
yes,
we?
Yes, for an age, yes.
Yeah, but we bonded.
How much did you bond?
Far too closely than Naomi would know about, I think, don't you?
Well, possibly, but, you know, you can't not bond with someone like Paul.
No, I mean, it's instant bondage, isn't it?
Instant bondage.
It is if the price is right, Joan.
Oh, indeed. We really need some drinks.
Good. You hold on here, I'll come and find you.
All right.
Right, yes, don't worry.
Sorry, it's Mr. a bit G. loud. We'd like some drinks right. for everybody.
If I may, I'll bring the mousse bouche straight away.
The what?
Thank you, yes.
Darling, mousse bouche. Did you know about this? Nico, qu'est-ce que c'est dans la mousse bouche?
A little fresh vegetable, cream.
It smells a bit fishy.
I think there's a little fish, but there's no shellfish.
Little fish.
Do you have an allergy to fish?
Not just an allergy, I would die, probably.
Yeah. Well, maybe don't go for that one, then. Give that one a miss.
Yes, I would just break out like a balloon. Would somebody test it?
I think maybe we should wait for Nico to find out.
There's no shellfish.
There's no fish in there.
No shellfish.
There's no shellfish.
What's in the bottom?
I've not...
Is there any fish
happened.
In it?
Oh,
no fish.
It's just
yeah.
vegetables.
No drinks. Oh, darling, that's definitely fish. Billingsgate must be like a ghost town.
How would you know?
I've got an allergy to shellfish.
How long have you got, dear?
Really? No, I didn't order it.
There's not been any real drama at the moment, apart from the fact that Joan is allergic to shellfish, and the starter turned out to be fish-derived. So there was a little momentary kind of session where we thought she might, you know, thankfully it didn't happen.
I don't know where that rumour started about it being shellfish, and I'm absolutely amazed that Nico even had to ask me, because I would not... Why would I put shellfish in an amuse-bouche?
Where's the bottle water?
Jam? It's rubbish.
Should I just take it in?
I would, yes. If has Nico asked you?
Yes. Yeah. Do you want to open your
Oh,
presents?
Yes. Can I go first?
Yes, you go first.
I'm so excited.
And if it's bigger and better than mine, I'm swapping.
I'm going to say it's going to be bigger and better than yours. The wrapping is fantastic. Lovely.
I didn't do it. It's Ben Halligan's.
Oh, lovely.
Yes. This is something that they do in America. They don't do it in England a lot.
I have got some eau de toilette. Courtesy of Ben Halligan's. Thank you very much. Thank you, Percy. Thank you.
You don't all have to open what you have.
Of course they do.
You know, they were giving little presents and everybody had nice food and the drink was flowing. And I couldn't imagine the guy who was sitting at the table up a ladder spraying.
Good for the beach.
you know, One Nation under CCTV. I just couldn't see it.
Oh, lovely, lovely. Oh, really, lovely. Thank you so much, darling. It's very nice.
You're welcome.
Absolutely lovely.
It's rather pretty, isn't it?
Yeah.
She gave me some aftershave from a very, very exclusive department store in, I think it was Mayfair. Wow.
Done experiments where if you put five rats in a cage or six rats, they get along really well. Then they multiply, and then it's 12, and then it's 18, and they start fighting with each other and get really, really angry. And I don't think that people are supposed to be. There's so many people. I mean, but his mother.
I'm sorry to interrupt them. There's a phone call for you.
For me?
Yep. It's a lady for you.
I'm sorry. Go, please, please. Absolutely. Yes. Yeah. No. Of course. Of course. Anyway.
How did they get our number?
Darling, it's on the call sheet.
Oh, it's on.
Yeah.
It's really awkward. It's really embarrassing. But of course my mobile's off. I'm working. We're doing the.
I'll just check the plates.
Oh, plates, yeah, because, I mean, it's all very well, Nico, but we do have to get the food out.
Well, if you had bothered to come, you'd know what we were doing. There's no point shouting at me now.
Bananas?
Sorry to interrupt you, Dan. Stephen's been away a little bit.
How long has he been gone?
Excuse
and
me,
then there were six,
yeah.
As Agatha Christie would say.
So he's left the table?
Yep.
And Joan is sitting there.
I think it's quite obvious. He keeps talking about putting the perfume on.
See, Tara, there's some men who like women, right?
Yes.
And some men
Daddy.
Who don't like women.
Okay. Like are you men. Just teaching her this now?
Well, actually, sorry. I think so you should be, and I think you owe Joan an apology, to be perfectly honest.
Aha! You're back!
Oh, yeah. I'm so sorry.
It's okay. Is everything okay?
Yeah, they're fine, thank you.
What happened?
Naomi.
Naomi, yeah.
No, she called you.
Exactly.
She sounds a bit neurotic.
I think she's a bit crazy myself.
Yeah,
Stephen, I'm glad you've apologised, because I think they're well owed an apology. What's going on?
Yeah, but why do you care?
Well, I do, because in actual fact, you know, I like Stephen, and I just kind of don't
know.
That's what I
said.
Well, he's a nice guy.
He is a nice guy, and very funny.
I'd like to take it a bit further.
But he's with someone. He's
well, I don't know that he is. Is he?
Maybe you just don't want him to be, so you're projecting what you're.
Yeah, but
what
when
you'd
you
like.
Say he's with someone in that kind of tone, what is the kind of moral?
Well, he's with a girlfriend, and she's trying to sort of.
But that's what I'm trying to ascertain, though. Right? Is he with somebody?
Is he?
Well, I mean, you can only be gay or straight.
You're right.
Maybe you could be bisexual.
It was all very, very strange, you know, how everybody focuses their attention. But when they've had a few to drink, it's kind of not spot on. And I think he seemed really together.
Excuse us.
Hello.
This is Mr. Brown.
Mr. Brown,
Mr. Brian, not Brown.
I said Brian.
It was almost as if, why should he be there? He was thinking to himself, why am I here?
He said we were obsessed with sexuality. Are we?
I mean, maybe he's got some issues.
No, I don't think he's got any sexual issues, guys. I travelled with him and he was just fine.
Yeah?
He didn't seem to have any confusion.
No, I do.
No.
But he's not like the others.
He's not. I don't think he's
not a lover, is he?
He's not gay. I don't know if he's a lover.
He doesn't
I don't
look
think
like,
he's
I, was, I saw him, you know, what, 2 seconds.
Yeah.
But it strikes me he's not gay.
But what's going on with you and her? I mean, you know, what's going are you. Are you gay or are you straight? I can't work you out.
You can ask him that question just across the dinner table.
Try and stop me, baby.
Thank you very much.
No, I can't work him out.
I don't think we need to talk about. I don't think we need to talk
about it. Well, maybe Naomi should know about it.
Yeah, but why do you care?
I don't know. I'm just. Look, to be perfectly honest with you, I really like you and I just would like to know where I stand, to be perfect. I don't want to put you in an embarrassing situation.
Oh, that sounds like such a woman. I'm sorry. I want to know where we stand and where we're going.
When Banksy was talking to Anne Mitchell, it almost looked on camera as if she was being persecuted for something. She definitely seemed to go back within ourselves.
But who are our role models then, Anne? Who are the people that we should look up to say we want to be like that?
Some people hero worship their parents. Some will hero worship their teachers. Some will hero worship Nelson Mandela and public figures like that. Of course, the need to worship or the need to have an idol like that is very primitive and basic.
Well, that's why I think the Queen is so important.
I agree.
Let us just have a little toast to the Queen.
Absolutely.
Not for me, I'm afraid. Shit.
Raise your glass, Anne. I know that you appreciate it.
And we can all make a speech to and for the Queen. And if you don't like the Queen, then you can just say, well, fuck her, and we'll go on to the next person.
Well, a little-known fact is that I'm, in all sense and purposes, the last-born of the Queen of England. You can see me in all the official photographs, admittedly at the back holding a tray.
You're there?
I'm there.
I hope you enjoy this. This is duck à l'orange.
I'm having the chicken, everyone, so please, you know, don't forget it.
Did you just want to share that with us?
Yes. Just so you know what's going into my mouth.
No, but my husband's a bit like, he doesn't eat duck either. He watches lots of football.
I watch a lot of footballers.
Well, that. But also, I was actually thinking more of Anne, how lucky she is.
I didn't get that, actually, tomorrow.
Oh. But if you don't have a husband, you know, most men watch gallons of football.
Well, did you ask Anne if she had a partner?
Well, she didn't answer, so I figured I'd be polite and let it drop.
Well, let her answer.
Let what drop? I don't know what it is you were asking.
No, sorry, my point was, I suppose, that you were lucky in the position, living with a woman, that you might not have to watch so much sport, I suppose, is what I was saying.
OK.
No, I just was kind of thinking that might be a perk, actually.
Are you asking me if I'm a lesbian?
I wasn't asking, actually. I presumed you... I was under the impression you were.
Why would you think that?
Tamara, that's very bold.
No. I looked it on Wikipedia.
Okay, yeah.
Lives with her partner, which I presume if you... So maybe I was presumptuous. I'm sorry, Anne. I'm very sorry, Anne. I was kind of...
Nothing to apologise. No. The only thing is that I would be ashamed of is not being out.
Yes.
Is not saying, yes, I'm a lesbian.
I hope you're listening to this, Steve.
I'm not. It's not a problem with me. What I have a problem about is that if I were a lesbian, I would be saying I was a lesbian. I'm not.
Absolutely not. We're all having a great time. We're having a lovely dinner, and we're all getting along just fine.
Brian, do you like souvenirs?
Yes.
You're a souvenir man.
Yes.
I am too. Scrapbooks and things and loads of stuff. Is there any more spare invitations around anyone?
I only want an invitation.
You brought yours, darling.
You
gave it to me. Oh. I've got your invitation.
I got my invitation.
So I stole Brian's, and Brian doesn't have one. And so.
Well, I could be generous and give him my one, Sharon.
No, but you need to keep yours.
All right, just, do you
want to
go?
But Tamara hasn't got an invitation either.
Tamara.
He
kept calling me Tara all the way here, so I had to stab him.
About them painting over one of your pieces
in
North London.
Yeah, that was disgusting.
How do you know it was mine? How do you know half the things are mine? There's a lot of someone making a lot of money out of what I do. A lot of yes. people making a lot
they
of money.
They are. Out of my... Commercialism. Let them all be flogged. Yeah.
I couldn't agree more. So and my mission is anti-capitalism, anti-war, and I said that before.
Are you really anti-capitalist?
Consumerism is eating us up.
Yes. Hello. I'm not putting this against my daughter. She has two children who are adorable. They have toys to the top of the room. When she was a child, she had maybe 15 toys. Yeah, and I had pen and paper and one doll. So in three generations... And it's not just yours, it's all of them. It's I want, I need, I have to have.
Yeah,
and it's the television, they see it on TV, and the parents just give into it because it's just so subliminally terrifying. And that's the consumer...
But you give into all your grandchildren?
Sometimes.
I have to say, I grew up in a society that... growing up in Peru in the 1970s, we had the first socialist... the first socialist dictatorship. And we grew up in a society that had no Santa Claus, no presents, no kind of joy of any sort. And I was thrilled to find consumerism actually gives a lot of people joy. It does. I'm sorry,
but too
I think
much
you
of it
underestimate
the amount
of joy.
And you just get so used to it and you just want more and more.
Not if you appreciate it.
But I totally agree with you. Mm-hmm. I mean, I have to admit, I'm a consumer. I always have been.
Yeah, this is like Alcoholics Anonymous,
isn't it?
Quiet.
But I'm not.
It
I only consume things that I can consume.
I'm here to network. If Banksy's here, I'm getting some art. That's my mortgage.
Oh, I'm up for this. Joan, on the napkin, please, darling. Your name?
What, me?
Yes, please. Please. Oh, my God. Fantastic. Love it.
I want one as well.
Thank you.
Oh, that's amazing. Can I have something, please?
The blues right out of the harmony.
Thank you.
think it went fantastically well. The mix of guests was phenomenal. Anne Mitchell was great because she was so sort of serious.
Hello, Anne. Oh. I have a quick word with you just before you you get off.
Oh, you're kidding. Yeah, OK, yeah. It was absolutely extraordinary. Not the beginning, I felt. When we got to the dinner table, I found that to be quite incredible. We had a moment when I thought Banksy was very judgmental. You know, he left the table, and it left the rest of us at the table feeling, oh my God, what have we done? When I challenged him and asked him about it, he said he just wanted to go to the loo. I don't really believe him, but there you go. Yeah, it was challenging.
The food was excellent, the wine is really good, and the two boys, they were just great. Absolute genius.
Of course, oh, of course, of course. Right.
Yeah, it's a bit dark, isn't it? Stop it.
I didn't mean that.
It was awful. Well, I got a phone call, which I wasn't expecting, kind of just after the starter, and Paul had to kind of show me the error of my ways.
Well, it was bad timing, wasn't it, to be perfectly honest with you?
And I felt the atmosphere kind of change, but I kind of redeemed myself.
You apologised, and I think that you made up for it.
But I'd love to be a fly on the wall to see what was said when I had to leave the room.
Paul, did you enjoy yourself?
I had a ball, actually. It was so great. I was really nervous about seeing Joan at such close proximity at this kind of function, and she was so fantastic and so sort of relaxing to be around, and so was Percy. Joan is the hostess with the mostest of the ball. Bum, 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 bum.
I agree with that. Good night, everybody.
I was really worried that a couple of the people I wouldn't get along with or I wouldn't really like, or, you know, they'd be too left-wing, you know how right-wing I am, but it worked really well. Tamara, and of course, Banksy, Brian, I mean, they were just great. They sort of went against each other. It was really fun.
For a few potatoes.
I'll just get you to stand here. We'll have just a few words from you on the evening.
Well, this is a bit like leaving the Big Brother house. It was definitely different. I think Joan had a super time. I think she had lots of different conversations, and I think once she kind of got over the fact that the chef nearly tried to, you know, poison them with some shellfish, she was on really good form, and I think it was just like a really lovely, normal, well, not normal, but, you know, a very smart, formal dinner party. Why have you gone all defensive again? You were so relaxed in there. Now look, your feet are apart, arms are crossed.
Because it's
all the intrusiveness, yeah. Mm-hmm. I think he's had enough of you. I'm afraid he's got to go home now.
Is that it? You sure? Nothing more?
It was different to what I expected, but we got through it.
I think he's got to get back to his world. I think he's had enough of fluff, haven't you?
This is the only time I'm going to do it. I'm never going to go and do all this again. It was like a nightmare.
17 hours of fabulous footage. Is that all you need?
It was perfect.
Perfect. Yeah, sure.
Let's go. Good night.
But you got to try everything once, so I did it. That's it.
Good night.
Would it be fair to say that it was probably the most exciting project you've ever worked on, the highlight of your career?
No.